Do you spend a lot of time on your mailbox? Imagine starting your day with a good cup of coffee without any stress, just concentrating on what you really need to do because you do not have to read through your emails. Sounds like a dream? Stay with me and let's make it happen together. I'm Zsófia of Myprocesses and I help busy entrepreneurs to automate and outsource their time-consuming tasks without sacrificing the profit. So if you are looking to make the 4-hour work week a reality or simply avoid burnout, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to get notified when I release a new video like this. In this video, we will look into the steps how to hire efficiently and affordably a good virtual assistant who can help you to manage your emails. I highly recommend you to check out my previous video that is about how to eliminate and automate your mailbox before you go for outsourcing. In the Myprocesses team, we allocate ideal virtual assistants to our clients and we ask them to follow the below 5 steps to make the outsourcing efficient. Step 1. Give access. The virtual assistant you have to trust in and you have to let her into your mailbox to actually manage those emails. So you have to think about how will you give her access. The most easy but less safe mode is to give her the login details. A more safer option you have is to use a password management system. I recommend you LastPass. LastPass will enable you to share the login with the assistant without sharing the password. It's also very handy because the assistant can easily find you in her own LastPass account. Step 2. Decide who will sign the emails. When your virtual assistant sends an email to one of your contacts, you have to decide whether it's signed in your name or she will sign her name on behalf of you as your virtual assistant. You don't have to use the same for everyone. You can have different contact lists and ask your virtual assistant to act accordingly. It would be really weird to send an email to your mother from your virtual assistant. Also, there are some VIP clients that can be very sensitive on this. So in my case, I always reply the email of my mother and the virtual assistant doesn't work on it. And also I always personally reply to my VIP clients. However, there are clients where I just ask the virtual assistant to handle the case and write it like I am Jim, Zsófia's virtual assistant. And that's fine. And I actually think it's very cool. But you have to think about whether your clients would appreciate this situation. If they don't, because for example, you are a coach and you are doing so personal care for them, then it might be better if your virtual assistant just stays behind the curtain and signs the emails as if she was you. Step 3, contact list. As I already mentioned, I always reply the emails of my mother. You also should have a kind of a contact list saying that these are my family members, I always want to reply personally. Also, I was already touching the point of having some VIP clients. You always want to make sure they are treated well, so you always reply personally. The shorter this list, the less time you have to spend in your mailbox. So if you really decide you let your inbox go, then you wouldn't have a list that you only can reply, all would go to the virtual assistant. And that's all fine, but you have to give clear instructions on to whom can she reply or not. Step 4. Collect and prepare in document frequently asked questions. What are the usual topics people emailing to you? How should they be replied? Write a few draft messages so your assistant can actually just go and take action. When she sees a certain kind of email, she will know that she has to use a certain kind of draft and send it and it's done. Or when you receive a meeting request and your assistants check your calendar, then she can decide whether she can accept this meeting request or not. Actually, if you put together step 3 and step 4, what you need to do is just sit down for like half an hour, go through your email list, see your emails one by one and decide what is the category of the email, who is the sender, what action do I usually take? Do I want my assistant to take action or do I want her to escalate this case to me every time? Then you can easily draft a certain kind of draft email that she can send without asking you. And then you also have to mark cases that needs to be always escalated to you in priority. So she will know that whenever she sees such kind of email, it has to be flagged for you to take action on this specific one, but not on the rest. Makes sense, right? Step 5, follow up. If you prepared this document in the previous steps with the draft and the instructions, you still need to revisit this. I recommend that in the beginning you have weekly calls with the assistant, weekly follow-ups, and then bi-weekly and maybe monthly. And I think it's still a good idea to give a dedicated time to your assistant when she can ask questions. And honestly, you have to be aware that there are no stupid questions in this case. You have to give her the freedom to ask, otherwise she would be too shy after a certain point to ask questions, and inevitably she's gonna make mistakes. So it's better to give her the time, the opportunity and the encouragement to ask questions. And these questions are very, very good, because if there is an issue which she could not solve on her own and she's asking you what to do, then you can put this information to the frequently asked questions document, and then she doesn't have to ask it again. Next time, she's just gonna know. Issue solved. I encourage you to take action today. Go to your mailbox and open a simple Excel document with 3 columns. Sender, topic, action. So list your usual senders and topic that you see you actually receive in your mailbox, and give an instruction to your future virtual assistant. This instruction can be save it to a folder, delete it, unsubscribe, or flag it to you, or send a draft email as a reply, and you can quickly write a draft reply as well. These are very important steps, and this document gonna be valuable. So if you have it, just leave a comment below and let's start working with your ideal virtual assistant. Until my next video, stop firefighting and be the creator of your company.